Hi all, this video is about how long it takes to boot Linux on the MyCPU. My name is Dennis Kuschel and I am the developer of the MyCPU. The MyCPU is an 8-bit computer system that I started developing in the year 2000. The homebrew CPU itself consists of 65 ICs from the 74HC CMOS logic series. The computer has 160 KB ROM and 1 MB RAM. The maximum clock frequency is approximately 8 MHz. The frequency itself depends on the workload, as the internal CPU clock cycles are shorter than the cycles during external bus accesses. In this experiment, I measured an average clock frequency of 8.2 MHz. From the beginning of the project, my dream was to emulate an x86 PC with my CPU and boot MS-DOS one day. But 24 years later, the now vintage MyCPU boots a modern Linux kernel. But how to boot Linux on MyCPU? The answer is emulating a RISC-V processor without reinventing the wheel. I found a great project on GitHub called MiniRV32IMA. Charles Lohr has written a minimalist RISC-V emulator consisting of just a C header file and a supporting C main file. On his GitHub page, he also provides a Linux image that runs on his emulator. The GitHub page also contains everything you need to build your own customized build root Linux. This is what I did. I quickly found out that the Linux kernel needs at least 16 MB of RAM to run stable, but MyCPU has only 1 MB. So I had to add a 16 MB memory extension to MyCPU. But how can I do this cheaply and easily, because I didn't want to pay a lot for this experiment? The solution was to use a cheap PS RAM and some logic in the form of a CPLD to glue the serial RAM to the 8-bit parallel bus of the MyCPU. For the CPLD, I used a cheap EPM240 dev kit, which I bought from AliExpress. I chose the EPM240 because it's too small to implement RISC-V in hardware, so nobody can say I'm cheating. The memory extension board is inserted into the rightmost slot in the MyCPU computer rack. Porting the MiniRV32IMA to MyCPU seemed easy at first. After adding the necessary memory support functions to the emulator, it was easy to cross-compile with my version of the CC65 compiler. But the emulator was damn slow. Booting Linux took about 15 hours. The solution was to rewrite everything in hand-optimized assembler code. This was tedious work, but successful. Linux now boots to bash in 52 minutes. If you want to reproduce my result, you can download everything you need from my homepage. Emulator source code, CPLD VHDL code, and PCB files. Thanks to Charles Lohr for his great work on the RISC-V emulator. Now let's see how MyCPU boots Linux to bash in 52 minutes.